Click on the Emis button, choose Reporting, Population Reporting. Then click on the Lewisham CCG Search and Report tab and go to the Diabetes folder and choose the subfolder Annual Recall Overdue Patients. Select a search, and as you can see in the Patients Included tab, at the CCG level, we are prohibited from viewing patient list or patient details. Therefore, for the purposes of this demonstration, I have created a dummy folder. So now if I click on the same search, I can now see patients included and two dummy patients. These searches are in two main sections. The first section deals with all patients that have an overdue annual diary date, i.e. they should have already have been called in. And the second section deals with patients you have a diary date in the next calendar month, i.e. those patients that are due to be called in. Let's start with the second section, recall all patients due next month. This is the query or search that you would run in order to send out your first recall letter, as these patients are due in the next calendar month. There is no need to send a letter to housebound patients, so these patients are excluded. And the next search picks up all those patients who are not housebound and therefore are due a first letter. In this example, there is one dummy patient who is due to be recalled, as he has a diabetic annual review date in the next calendar month. You can recall all the patients in your patients included list by clicking on Mail Merge. I'm selecting the included list, and I can select a document template for diabetes recall letter. I'm not going to print it. I am going to save it in patient's record, and here I can choose the read code for diabetes monitoring first letter. If I now rerun these searches, and I'll include all the child searches, you can now see that there are no patients due to be sent a first letter, as I've just sent it. And that patient has now moved down to the third query, all patients due next month that have been sent a first recall letter. Let's now look at the first section, reviewing all patients with an overdue annual diary date. This section is here to manage patients who have been recalled using the second section and whose diary date is now in the previous month but still in this current coif year. So in this first search, there are two patients with overdue annual diary dates. The next subquery excludes any patients who have come in for the annual review and who are still overdue. This should not happen, so any patients that appear in the patient excluded tab should be reviewed. The next query looks for patients who are overdue but have not had a first letter sent. There should be no patients that have not been sent a first letter. So if any patients do appear, you can use your Mail Merge tab to send a first letter out for those patients. These patients may have been sent a first letter, but then this letter has not been coded as 90L4. Second letter due, but not yet sent. This looks for any patient that has been sent a first letter more than 30 days ago, but has not yet been sent a second letter. Any patients that appear here can be sent a second letter using Mail Merge. Please add the second letter sent code 90L5. In the same way, a third letter can be sent out, and any patients who have been sent all three letters can then be reviewed by the clinical lead.